standoff. Adam Cole begging Ricochet to come and fight him in his ring. Two rings, the sinister structure. This is War Games 2.
Somewhat of a cautious start.
And Adam Cole able to bait Ricochet into his web. And Cole exploding on the NXT North American champion, but Ricochet immediately turns the tables, firing off a volley of right hands with a European uppercut to boot.
Come on, Adam. Oh! Like the crack of a whip. That chop landed hard.
Reversal on the Irish whip by Cole. Beautifully done by Ricochet, and Ricochet, head scissors takeover. Dynamic drop kick by the NXT North American champion. Remember, it was Adam Cole who made history earlier this year in a legendary six-man ladder match that included Ricochet. Ricochet came within, well, fingertips of becoming the inaugural NXT North American champion, only to be scuttled by Cole. But since then, Ricochet has rebounded, and he, being the NXT Skywalker.
You think this is your match, huh?
Yeah, a bit of trash talk, saying this is Cole's match. Referring, of course, to last year's War Games match.
Oh! And Ricochet gets caught into a backstabber by Adam Cole, well-timed.
Cole says no one can handle War Games like Undisputed Era, and he's showing us why. Take a look one more time. Picking Ricochet out of the air, backstabber applied.
Remember, it was Cole who recorded the victory courtesy of the last shot last year. And now Cole with the ground and pound on Ricochet.
You gotta think the Undisputed Era have to feel that advantage. They have to feel confident because they've been in this match before. They've been to hell and back.
Neckbreaker by Adam Cole continues to soften Ricochet, knowing full well that another member of the Undisputed Era will be the next to enter.
Not only
the
that,
cage.
Not only that experience advantage as well. The Undisputed Era, as a team, they've got each other's back. They know each other well.
Supercharged Alliance, though, facing off with them. The enemy of my enemy is my friend. With Ricochet now in a fireman's carry. Ushigaroshi by Cole, who had plenty of success in Japan and now dominating NXT as a member of the Undisputed Era.
The question is, that enmity for your opponents, is that a strong enough bond to form a team? I mean, if we think of the traditional 5-on-5 Survivor Series matches tomorrow night at Survivor Series, the teams there, it's just the brand that keep them together.
How about over here?
Adam Cole utilizing all of the real estate with the two rings, now continues to beat down Ricochet, keeping the preeminent high flyer grounded. And Adam Cole, as smart as they come when it comes to ring IQ, a champion wherever he has performed in his illustrious career.
Gotta say, that's one of the things I like most about Adam Cole is his patience in the ring.
Cole doing exactly what he needs to do and wear down his opponent. But fellas, think what happens in a couple of minutes. Another member of the Undisputed Era comes into the ring.
Shades of
and Adam Cole already has the advantage.
The Fantastics with Cole just raking Ricochet's face across the cage.
Conceivably, Ricochet could be taken out before the match officially even starts.
And Ricochet on the receiving end of a diverse attack from Adam Cole, attacking all areas of his anatomy, but Cole telegraphing the back body drop, and Ricochet putting the boots to Cole.
There's the life coming back into Ricochet.
Yeah, Ricochet showcasing his resiliency. Man who always wakes up in the sky, man who has no fear as NXT North American champion, and on cue! Springboard soaring European uppercut by Ricochet!
That's it, Nigel Morrow, you said it. You cannot hesitate. You cannot show fear inside this cage. You must be ready for anything at all times.
Oh, we're down, there we are, 10 seconds left until one member of the Undisputed Era comes down. And if you're Ricochet, oh dear. Who's it gonna be?
Member of the UE, will it be? Referee unlocking the shark cage. It will be. What? Oh, and it's gonna be Kyle O'Reilly who earned the advantage. Wednesday on NXT TV.
Almost seemed like a moment of hesitation, but not from Kyle O'Reilly now.
And immediately, in the land of palm trees, it's Kyle O'Reilly looking to obliterate Ricochet with those open palm strikes.
And the Undisputed Era now have a 3-minute advantage.
Cole has time to recover.
Man, O'Reilly looking to just skeletonize Ricochet like O'Reilly was a piranha and Ricochet was a water buffalo. And now Cole and O'Reilly with the numbers advantage.
Forget about recovering. If I'm Adam Cole, I want to put Ricochet away now when I've got this advantage.
Cole and O'Reilly, two-thirds of the winning version of the Undisputed Era last year at the first NXT War Games match. And Ricochet. Nice right hand and a right hand for Cole and Ricochet. Ricocheting off both O'Reilly and Cole. Dragon screw leg whip. By O'Reilly.
Is that now three members of the Undisputed Era's opponents with bad knees?
And the Undisputed Era has done a great job of taking liberties with their opposition, attacking Hanson, Pete Dunne, and now Ricochet's lower limbs. And a Muay Thai plum with knee strikes, and wow, you talk about tag team position. You gotta say the Undisputed Era, all four members with more chemistry than a science fair, and these are sports entertainment scientists working their craft right now on Ricochet.
Cole said last year, this is things where things really began to start for him. This is where they began to take over NXT. And you got to think, if they win this year, what does that mean for NXT going forward?
NXT Universe trying to rally behind Ricochet, knowing odds are against the current NXT North American champ. But Ricochet drives Cole into O'Reilly and uncorks a right hand on Kyle O'Reilly before a bicycle kick meets the face of Ricochet.
Hold on.
Oh, an assist.
Oh, man.
An assist from O'Reilly and another Ushigaroshi from Adam Cole, whether it be Japan or North America. O'Reilly and Adam Cole, two of the best.
And now finally Ricochet is going to get some help. Guys, think if you're Ricochet, 15 more minutes until the match even starts officially.
The question is it too late, though? Ricochet looks out of it.
War Raiders and Dunne. Whoa! But if Hanson keeps Dunne from entering, and Hanson, who lost to Kyle O'Reilly for the advantage on Wednesday, he wants retribution. Instead, he's mauled by O'Reilly and Cole momentarily.
He's a bigger man. He can absorb most punishment.
He's also going to get tired earlier in a match.
And of course, Ricochet will be given an opportunity to recover as it's Hanson laying waste now to members of the Undisputed Era. Remember Killian Dane, an MVP performance for sanity in a losing effort at last year's War Games. And look at Hanson. Guys, his eyes aren't supposed to be able to move like this.
Again, guys, this is valuable time for Ricochet to recover. If Hanson can keep this pace going, this would put this team back in contention in this War Games match.
It's a fair point. Hanson here picking his opponents.
Corner clotheslines. A cornucopia of corner clotheslines by Hanson.
Hanson is expending a lot of energy. Running corner to corner nonstop.
He's keeping his team alive.
Trained by the legendary Killer Kowalski, and Hanson showing the killer instinct here early. Wow! Hanson with a tour de force!
sucking air. Ready to attack again.
Cannonball coming through.
Bronco Buster on both O'Reilly and Cole, driving the air out of their lungs. And the air that is going to become, well, so premium as this match unfolds. And now Ricochet back on his feet, joining Hansen. And for the time being, the odds are even.
Absolutely, in terms of numbers. And if you take a look in the ring now, both members of Undisputed Era down. What's this?
Oh, Ricochet and Hansen teaming up.
Showtime is what it is.
Shooting star press off the back of Hansen by Ricochet.
Some nice teamwork there.
One more time, take a look at Ricochet. Shooting star press,
and
big impact.
Ricochet lands hard across the rib cage of Kyle O'Reilly. Oh. Adam Cole playing possum and led Hansen into an elbow, but down. O'Reilly coming to Cole's aid. Cole now dropping some elbows. Again, no pinfalls or submissions. The War Games match yet to officially begin. This is all about beating the hell out of your opposition.
There is Ricochet, who has absorbed a lot of punishment early in this match.
And has also meted out his own unique brand of punishment. Again, the advantage to the Undisputed Era, their third member about to enter. And it's gonna be Roderick Strong, who you'll recall at last year's War Games was a member of the team with the Authors of Pain. He was in fact an opponent of the Undisputed Era, but not tonight.
Roderick Strong completely fresh, tearing into both Ricochet and Hansen.
What a drop kick by Roderick Strong!
Just picking apart his opponents.
Oh, step up knee in the corner. One half of the NXT Tag Team Champions laying waste to War Raiders and the Uranagi across the knee. And another one. The Messiah of the Backbreaker, as innovative as they come, putting Ricochet in a torture. And dropping Ricochet across both of Strong's knees. Strong with a strong effort, to say the least.
Using Ricochet as a missile. Hold on.
Strong got caught by Hansen, and then it's Cole that kicks Hansen in the face. Axe kick, and the forearm smashed by O'Reilly. And look at the Undisputed Era. What a trio.
Now the numbers game come back into play. Can't see the time, but he's got to have at least 2 minutes left to put some big punishment.
Undisputed Era, as close a stable as you will ever find in sports entertainment. These warriors have traveled together for years. They battled each other over the years and found the common good in the Undisputed Era.
How's that feel, Hansen?
And boy, the Undisputed Era just decimating Hansen and Ricochet.
How's it feel?
Strength in numbers. NXT Tag Team Champions teeing off on Ricochet.
Ricochet dropped there.
And by the way, the match War Games yet to officially begin, guys. Look at the punishment being meted out by the Undisputed Era. Teamwork makes the dream work.
I said before, didn't I? By the time this match starts, Ricochet, to all intents and purposes, be useless.
I can't even imagine what it'll be like when all competitors would be in the ring. Based on how it looks right now, it's gonna be
the second consecutive win at War Games for Undisputed Era, is what you're saying. If this continues, the onslaught by O'Reilly, Cole, and Strong, and now in less than 10 seconds, we will be even once again in terms of numbers in the ring. Will it be Rowe or Dunn? They're both fighting to get in, and it's gonna be Rowe, the other half of the War Raiders.
Well, doesn't that speak volumes? Both men fighting to get in. They hadn't made the decision beforehand.
Like, they're not
Not on the same page.
Well, not like the Undisputed Era, that's for sure, but they better get on the same page in a hurry at that row.
Whoa!
Wow, what a suplex!
Look, War Raiders aren't the type of guys that create strategies. They just want to brawl.
Gutbuster into the gut wrench. Oh, forearm by Cole, but
What
an explosive psycho knee by Rowe. And look at the striking display of one half of the War Raiders, Rowe.
Oh, but that rear naked sleeper hold there.
O'Reilly training in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu in his native British Columbia.
Whoa! Oh!
The thick neck of Ray Rowe protecting himself there. Tucking that chin, protecting the carotid artery.
Rowe scoops up O'Reilly. Hansen puts strong.
What? The power of Rowe, unbelievable. Can you say momentum shift? Look at this. Look at the power of Rowe of War Raiders. And check out the impact on both Kyle O'Reilly and Roderick Strong.
That's got to be nearly 450 pounds driven into the mat.
Another tremendous night for NXT TakeOver. Currently the number one trend worldwide. And five of the top 10 trends on the planet all have to do with NXT TakeOver War Games and the sequel already living up to what transpired a year ago.
Look at the face of Adam Cole now.
Look where he's backing up to, right into Ricochet.
Oh, Cole is surrounded.
Uh-oh.
And Cole, Ricochet pushes him right into the War Raider.
Right the
battering ram face first into the cage goes Adam Cole.
Well, that's an interesting point, isn't it, about the order of entrance. Yes, if you come in first, you have an advantage, but if you come in second, your man's a lot fresher.
War Raiders enjoy smiting foes on the field of battle. Ooh.
Again, the right arm from Ricochet. Oh, finding a second wind.
Oh,
he may have to find a third and a fourth wind before the end of it.
Oh.
As now the final member of the Undisputed Era will make his way to the ring. No question who it is.
Bobby Fish, who made an instant impact in his return. Bobby Fish is going. And he just
what is he doing?
He just locked Pete Dunne. Oh, but Pete Dunne attacking the finish. What's Bobby Fish doing? Bobby Fish is supposed to be headed to the War Games, but instead, must be Bobby.
Oh my God! Is he looking?
He's
looking
Pete Dunne in the shark cage, and he's got the key.
Fish used a padlock from his cage to lock the other team's shark cage.
The Undisputed Era began with an advantage. Bobby Fish is ensuring that they may have the advantage for the rest of this match. And remember, what? You gotta be kidding me. He just threw away the key, and guys, Pete Dunne has to make it into the cage in order for War Games to be official. And now, Bobby Fish with his trusted chair.
Undisputed
Bobby Fish,
Era
the chairman
chairs.
Of the board of the Undisputed Era.
This is clearly premeditated. What a brilliant plan from the Undisputed Era.
Bobby Fish and Kyle O'Reilly with a concerto on one half of the War Raiders, Hanson. And there's...
We see that time clock in the bottom corner, 2 minutes, 50 seconds. But when that runs out, it won't matter.
Pete Dunne can't. Pete Dunne's locked in the cage, and Bobby Fish threw away the key. And until Dunne gets into the mat, Maxim, it doesn't officially start.
Eric has all this time with the one-man advantage. What is this team? What is Ricochet?
It's bad enough that they have the numbers advantage. They're each in possession of chairs, and they're using those chairs to destroy their opponents.
Mangling those Undisputed Era chairs.
This is big trouble for Ricochet and War Raiders.
And guys, think about this. If Dunn somehow escapes the cage and gets into the mat, it's going to be 4-on-1 because the Undisputed Era's decimating the War Raiders and Ricochet.
And that's if. What an absolutely brilliant strategy from the Undisputed Era.
Undisputed Era brutalizing Hansen of the War Raiders.
I don't know who came up with it, but they need a medal.
It was obviously premeditated, a plan that had been put into effect. As Rowe gets put through the chair by Roderick Strong. And have we ever seen the Undisputed Era look stronger?
I guess Roderick Strong didn't get all of it, but it doesn't matter because it sure was effective.
And it helps that it's 4-on-3 with the fourth member of the other team in purgatory right now.
Well, we talked about the physicality, the brutality of the War Games matches. We didn't necessarily talk about the intelligence of the teams, and that's been the biggest factor in this match.
That's why the Undisputed Era rose so quickly in the NXT ranks. Oh, wow, almost putting Rowe right through the cage. And again, this match yet to begin officially, and look at the carnage. Bobby Fish, of course, recovering from that leg injury, was on the shelf for a long period of time, but came back and, well, he made impact with the chair.
Absolutely, and then Ray Rowe, I think, made impact on Bobby Fish's injured leg.
In fact, War Raiders blame Bobby Fish, Percy, for not being the NXT Tag Team Champions. They had a shot at the titles before Bobby Fish made a shocking return.
The time ticking down, but fellas, at this point, it's academic. Hey, obviously, clearly. Oh, they found the key.
Did they?
That was for the original.
That was for the original lock.
Well, let's see if
my key doesn't work on this one.
He threw the other key.
Of course it doesn't. It's the wrong key.
Pete Dunne is apoplectic, desperately trying to get out of the cage so we can officially begin War Games, but the other key was thrown away by Bobby Fish, and that may have thrown away the chances of Dunne, Ricochet, and War Raiders in this match.
We need to get some officials out into the NXT universe, see if they can find that key.
Well, they got to stop wasting time and find a way to get Pete Dunne out of there to back his team up, because this is going sideways real quick.
Chance of Bruiserweight Pete Dunne doing his best to try to break the chains.
They try and get some bolt cutters out there or something. Obviously, I had any idea that this could have happened.
Last year it was Roderick Strong who avalanche German suplexed Adam Cole, but now, wow! Strong with another suplex.
Oh, man.
Bobby Fish with one. And the Undisputed Era simply laying waste. And Cole mocking the Bruiserweight Pete Dunne. Oh, man, there's going to be hell to pay.
This freaking show.
Cole saying they run this freaking show. And it appears that the Undisputed Era are running Los Angeles tonight. Wait,
Nigel,
the witch is their command. They managed to find bolt cutters, and you know Pete Dunne is gonna bolt out of that cage.
But at this juncture, Mara, what's the point?
What's the point?
It's gonna be 4-1.
It's the Bruiserweight, the WWE UK champion Pete Dunne, hampered by an injury, dragging himself to the ring.
Dunne's already hobbling down there.
Pete Dunne doesn't care if he only had one leg. He's still be trying to get
that ring. And look at O'Reilly trying to keep Dunne from entering the cage. Oh, the kendo stick. Pete Dunne came to play as well. Oh, and wrapping the knuckles of Fish and O'Reilly, and Cole now trying to thwart Dunne's entrance.
Wait a second.
Oh. And remember, when Pete Dunne officially enters the cage, War Games will officially begin, and that is why Undisputed Era doing their best to keep him out.
Well, Dunne doing the right thing, trying to get some help.
Ricochet on the top! Ricochet wipes out Undisputed Era, and it's a brand new ball. game here at War Games.
Well, so focused on Dan on the outside, that gave Ricochet the chance to recuperate.
And John looking to take out the garbage in the form of Undisputed Era, and yet he's still yet to officially enter the ring so we can officially begin War Games.
The United Kingdom champion, Pete Dunne.
Here we go.
Raising the stakes.
Dunne bringing in the heavy artillery. He would like to set a table for four. All four members of the Undisputed Era, that is. And all hell is about to break loose. Bedlam about to break out. Pete Dunne's not finished. He's the moving man. Introducing another table. Pete Dunne on the steps, grabs a hold of the kendo stick, and he's in the ring. Let the War Games begin. Pete Dunne going to town on Roderick Strong with the kendo stick. Ooh. The number one trend worldwide all night long, NXT TakeOver. And
War Games now officially started.
If anyone leaves the cage during the match, that superstar's team will automatically lose when someone is pinned or made to submit. War Games is over.
Ricochet and the War Raiders have made an astonishing recovery. Where are they finding this energy from? Uh-oh.
Oh, wow, and Undisputed Era on the receiving end of this onslaught. Ricochet slamming the kendo stick down across the back. Oh, Riley lands hard on that partition in between the two rings.
Still good between
and
the rings.
And with apologies to David Beckham, it's bended like a cruiserweight.
He done doing what he does best. Watch this.
A propensity for finger food, especially when it's his opponent's digits. And it's all Ricochet, War Raiders, and Pete Dunne. Pete Dunne has changed the complexion of this match.
You are not kidding. The numbers are equal. But if you take a look at the ring, the Undisputed Era's opponents.
The manipulation of Kyle O'Reilly's joints, courtesy of Pete Dunne. And that will affect the grip of Kyle O'Reilly.
Let's remember now, at any point this match could end with a pinfall or submission. X-Plex.
X-Plex followed O'Reilly, but the knee by Cole. And now Adam Cole. With an opportunity to get the Undisputed Era back into this War Games match. Remember, it was Cole that captured the victory for the Undisputed Era last year. Oh, O'Reilly.
And he got hit in the head with it.
And he just did, courtesy of Hansen. Wanton behavior.
Oh, what an incredible flagrant show of brutality.
Oh, and now Hansen. Taking out Adam Cole with the trash can and the tandem offense of the War Raiders.
Taking punishment to give punishment.
And boy, did they do a number on that trash can.
Look at this, full steam ahead with Adam Cole trapped inside.
War Raiders are psyching themselves up, and
what is
Hansen
this?
Has Roe up, and Hansen body slams the bigger, or make that Roe body slams Hansen on Kyle O'Reilly.
Lower back at Hansen, ramming into that steel girder. Somehow, adrenaline not feeling it.
War Raiders more than happy to join the raid of War Games.
Nasty landing, high and across the back.
And again, the cover, oh! And Bobby Fish with a presence of mind to keep War Games going.
Not for much longer.
And again, War Raider. Oh, my, that garbage can just bounced off the cranium of Hansen. And now it's Fish and O'Reilly.
Rowe fighting two on one. Not much longer he can withstand that sort of offense.
And the pack mentality here by the Undisputed Era, Fish and O'Reilly. A dominant tag team for many years.
Go.
It was Fish and O'Reilly who won the NXT tag team titles over Sanity last year.
Tides are turning yet again. It's looking like all Undisputed Era here. Only one standing is Ricochet.
Ricochet now in the fireman's carry of Roderick Strong. Oh, the backstabber by Adam Cole, realigning the spine of Ricochet.
And of course, tomorrow night at Survivor Series is the battle for brand supremacy. Tonight, the Undisputed Era have War Games supremacy on mine.
Pete Dunne surveying the landscape, the dangerous landscape. Surrounded, and Pete Dunne, the cruiserweight, showcasing his fighting heart.
Dunne trying to fire the first volley, but never going to have the better of four men.
But he just got the better of Cole, and he just got the better of Fish, and he just got the better of Strong. You were saying, Nigel McGuinness.
Let me take those words back.
Oh, and Zagiri catches O'Reilly. Rolling into the knee bar. And looking for that angle.
Don't forget, the match could end at any point. If Bobby Fish submits, this is the end. This could be the end.
The surgically repaired leg of Bobby Fish.
Fish writhing in agony.
Dunne taking out all four members of Arrow.
For the victory, but Kyle O'Reilly able to short circuit that submission attempt.
Oh, no.
O'Reilly now with a chain.
Where did that come from? Well, I suppose it doesn't matter where it came from. It only matters where it is in the hands of Kyle O'Reilly. And now around the ankle of Pete Dunne.
And remember, Dunne also injured in that brouhaha to close out NXT TV this past week. And O'Reilly looking to exploit that on Dunne's injured leg, but Dunne doing his best to fight off, and he's manipulating the joints of O'Reilly. Now into the Kimura.
Double
and the chain wrapped around that hand.
Look at the way Dunne's holding a finger. He's got the chain.
The power of O'Reilly and the chair shot from Fish onto the injured leg of Pete Dunne. And O'Reilly continues to wrap the chain around the injured leg of Pete Dunne.
Ankle
needs some help. He needs his guys. He needs his guys.
A submission.
Will Dunne tap?
Great victory to the Undisputed Era.
Deep breath.
Look at the Undisputed Era fending off anybody else from preventing this. Will we see a tap?
Era's trying to put up a wall so the rest of the team can't get over there to help out Pete Dunne.
Through the veins of Pete Dunne. Pete Dunne now. Wow, Pete Dunne now being double teamed by Strong and O'Reilly. Strong using the chair.
How can Dunne withstand much longer? How can Dunne survive?
Flying through the air is only he can do. Oh, but a chair to the midsection by Strong.
How on earth did Pete Dunne hang on?
Big back body drop sent Strong into the other ring. And it's just complete carnage here at the Staples Center. Bodies lying all over both rings. The only man standing is Hansen of the War Raiders. And now, while O'Reilly was standing momentarily.
Like the scene out of an apocalypse. Bodies strewn everywhere.
O'Reilly and Strong perched on the top turnbuckle by the War Raiders. And they are working in synergy. Oh, but Adam Cole blasts Hansen in the back.
Vicious kick by Ricochet.
It is so hard to get a pinfall or submission when there are so many other competitors in the ring that can interfere and break it up.
Oh, what a shot by Pete Dunne.
What that means is you have to completely wear out every member of your opposing team.
And I think we are very near that to that point.
How is Pete Dunne?
Wow, Ricochet.
Back on the top rope.
Pete Dunne.
This man isn't human.
Unbelievable. Double Edge Stereo, mamma mia, Ricochet! Cover! Have he done?
Oh. The end
guard for the cup. Oh! To your point, Nigel, great opportunity there by Ricochet.
Tandem offense right here by both Ricochet and United Kingdom champion Pete Dunne.
You saw Dunne there grabbing at the knee, couldn't pin, make a pinfall attempt afterwards.
And now War Raiders momentarily bridging the two rings with the table. But the amount of punishment that all eight Warriors have absorbed, how much is left in this, the soul-stealing structure that is War Games? A match that alters careers.
Oh! Oh! Enhancer! Punching Adam Cole!
The legs gave way. And that doesn't mean Hansen can't put it back up
and, even
and inflict more punishment.
Even the hardware has been subjected to its abuse here in what has been a titanic struggle here in War Games. Oh, wow.
Don't try to get away. He got caught. Fighting for his life.
Oh, but Cole pop up into the power slam. War Raiders now had to go for the
cover.
War Raiders. Oh, O'Reilly with a chair to the back of Hansen. And now Rowe looking again, but Bobby Fish behind him with a kendo stick. Crashing it across the back.
Rowe was aware at the last second.
Oh! And Rowe just got put through the table. And the vestiges of battle all over the bodies, the welts, the bruising.
Listen to the impact. Driving Rowe through the table.
Bobby Fish blasts Rowe through the table. And now Adam Cole unloads on Ricochet. The first team to score a pinfall or submission will be claimed the victors of War Games.
Well, it's back to the two men that started the War Games match, Ricochet and Adam Cole.
It wasn't the official War Games match. They started the first sequence here to get things going at Staples Center. Adam Cole and Ricochet have been in there longer than any other superstar, and now Cole tied to the Tree of Woe, but it's O'Reilly that thwarts the attack of Ricochet for a moment anyway.
Look at the fight of Ricochet staying alive.
Got to give it to Ricochet. Remember how much punishment he absorbed for the early part of this match.
But if anyone that has a second, third, or maybe even fourth win is this man right here, Ricochet.
But it speaks volumes, doesn't it, about what a great strategy it was to put Ricochet in first.
The blood rushing to the head of Adam Cole as he continues to be tied to the Tree of Woe. Roderick Strong with a jumping knee to the jaw of Ricochet. And now the triangle being employed by O'Reilly on the table on Ricochet. If Ricochet taps, the War Games match is over.
Was that?
Oh no, Hansen. Hansen on one leg jumps across. And Hansen wipes out O'Reilly. War Raiders almost won War Games for their team. Wow. What a splash through the table as Hansen makes a big splash at War Games. And the carnage speaks for itself.
Hey guys, look at this. Hansen from War Raiders trying to put this thing away. Look at the distance covered by the big man.
Use the ropes from the other ring. And were it not for Roderick Strong, the savior of the Undisputed Era, this terrible match would be over.
All eight NXT superstars struggling, trying to find it within their soul, within their mind, how they can do the next to impossible, somehow, some way, find a way to claim victory for their team in this battle for the ages. Cole, the only one on his feet, and he's barely hanging on, using the ropes. It was Adam Cole that earned the victory in the first War Games match last year with the last shot at Adam Cole.
Wait, what?
Oh, wow.
If Adam Cole escapes and if Adam Cole lands on the floor or Rick
Ricochet, their team loses. What are they doing?
Well, that can't be what Adam Cole had in mind.
There's no way.
I wonder what he had in mind. Oh, wow.
Perhaps was looking for some offensive maneuver, and he may, unfortunately, be on the receiving end of one now.
Ricochet and Cole in the most perilous position you can be in here at War Games, the top of the cage.
We think back over the annals of sports entertainment, the damage that we've seen.
And remember, Roderick Strong. Oh, wait, they're going to push Ricochet off the cage. Ricochet falls to the outside. Undisputed Era wins.
This is genius again. You know what Cole did? He went up top to bait Ricochet up there, knowing he could throw Ricochet out and win the match. That's absolute genius. Tell me I'm a liar.
Cole done. Strong and Ricochet on the fence. You're absolutely right, Nigel, but look where Cole finds himself. They're all in a perilous position. They were in a perilous position when they signed to compete at War Games.
Oh, look at the knee of Pete Dunne, the right knee that was injured.
Look at how Pete Dunne has Adam Cole hooked, though. Set him up for a suplex. This could be bad.
The numbers continue to grow. Oh, wow. Oh, this is not going to end well for Adam Cole. Bobby Fish. What is...
Look at
Fish.
That. Look at this.
Oh, Fish trying to choke out Hansen, but what the...
Look at this.
What in the hell was that? Incredible.
Hey, guys, this is... This is War Games. Prepare to expect the unexpected. Bodies just sprawled out all over the place. One more time.
And the best view in the house belonged to Ricochet.
An avalanche of humanity.
An avalanche indeed as Ricochet on the top of the cage beginning to stir as the seven other superstars trying desperately to get to their feet. What is Ricochet thinking?
Oh, no.
No. Don't tell me Ricochet, the preeminent high flyer.
Showtime, baby.
Cirque du Ricochet in full effect.
The North American champion said if he gets to the top of this cage, it would get crazy. He fulfilled his promise, because that was absolutely insane.
A different angle. The spin, the rotation.
This is a man that can fly, doesn't need a cape, doesn't need wings. X marks the spot. Ricochet takes out everybody.
Rotation moonsault. And the look on the NXT Universe faces say it all. There is only one Ricochet, the NXT North American champion.
Now both teams, by osmosis.
Both teams brutalizing each other, Nigel.
Forming.
And it's time to regroup for both the Undisputed Era, the War Raiders, Ricochet and Pete Dunne.
All eight gladiators.
And it is ridiculous, if you ask me, the fact that all eight are standing.
A line drawn in the sand.
Wow, a classic standoff here at War Games.
A steel girder between armies. Here we go.
War Games is about to be taken to the next level.
You think this is your time? Trench warfare!
And all hell has broken loose at War Games!
An alleyway of brutality! Who came out on top? I don't know.
Well, it's Rowe who's standing for the moment before he gets taken down by a desperate Bobby Fish. And after all of this, we are back to even terms, you guys. It has been an astounding display. Manhandling Bobby Fish and just destroying his jaw with that knee, and the War Raiders now setting up Bobby Fish. Fall out! And O'Reilly, though, quick to grab the neck of Rowe, but here comes Strong! And Strong blasted Rowe with the kick!
High-low combination took down Rowe. Here's Hansen.
It's the last stand for the Undisputed Era.
You see Hansen just run right through.
Double back elbow. Come on. Hansen with a handspring double back elbow. I know it's a nightmare for those involved, but I must be dreaming because I can't believe what we are seeing. Double. Manipulates the toes and then the fingers.
Here it is.
Looking for the... Oh, what a counter into the DDT by Adam Cole. And there it is. Adam Cole looking to put Pete Dunne away with the last shot. Is it a repeat? Is it a repeat? Adam Cole's exposed his knee. Adam Cole looking to send the Undisputed Era to victory, but now Pete Dunne! And will it be the bitter end of this brutal battle?
Ricochet
flying through the air! And both Ricochet and Dunne have full cover, they win! They win! Wow!
Your winner, the team of the War Raiders, the NXT North American champion Ricochet, and the WWE United Kingdom champion, Pete Dunne
and Ricochet both pin Adam Cole, and a standing ovation here from the 13,600 in attendance at the Staples Center, witnessing another brutal chapter of NXT history.
What an incredible match.
And none of these superstars will ever be the same physically, mentally, spiritually. And now, Ricochet and Pete Dunne collect their wares. They both pinned Adam Cole.